Get ready to match the star. Jimmy Walker, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Bell, Kate Jackson, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Grabber.
Care what your agents told you. You're going to have a good time.
Sure.
All right?
Yeah.
Good times. Jay. And the rookies. I got to get all the things accounted for. Now let's say old Velma Murray and Julie Wingate, ladies. She's rich. She is rich. $14,650.
To my show.
You hear what she said?
What?
She said, I just want to welcome you to my show. Now, how are we doing here? We're in the middle of round two, beginning of round two. You've each had your first round questions. At this moment, the score is 3-0 in favor of Julie. And she's a very happy lady. We'll see how this game turns out in just a minute or so. Come right back. Now, here we go. Round two coming up. Julie, it's your choice, A or B.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Three people do not play. The lower tier does not play. This is for the upper tier only. Upper tier, wake up. Here, here.
What? Huh?
At the Chinese restaurant, Harold's fortune cookie read as follows. Foolish customer, while you sit here reading fortune cookie, dishonorable waiter is taking your brank.
Remember me.
Some dumb lady. Foolish customer, while you sit here reading fortune cookie, dishonorable waiter is taking your blank.
Reading fortune. Well, there were so many choices.
Oh, there's one very good one.
There
and
is?
One really terrific one. Okay.
Oh, that's not the good one, honey.
Well, that's one of the good ones. All right.
No, don't say that.
Okay.
Well, wait a minute.
That's it. All right.
Hi,
everybody,
Kate.
Ready over there? Julie.
I'm scared, Kate Jackson.
At the Chinese restaurant, Harold's fortune cookie. Red. Foolish customer, while you sit here reading fortune cookie, dishonorable waiter is taking your blank.
Car. Car.
Car. She says car. That's one we got to go with, and it's a groaner. You're right,
car.
Julie. It's a groaner. Jimmy, she said car.
Well, she has a comfortable lead. No,
he
I...
He broke himself with that rotten joke.
I said money.
Money.
Thank you, Cloud. Yeah, now we're cooking. All right.
Okay.
Well, where would a person keep their money?
In a wallet or purse.
Or in a purset.
In a purset, okay. Two good answers so far, Dad. Charles.
I'm dying.
Let me see what's in my cookie.
Fortune cookie. Open fortune cookie.
Coat.
Coat. So we got money and purse and coat, and that's it. No car thieves around here. Now, Velma, 3-4. You ready, Velma?
Sure.
Sure. She's resigned to the whole thing here. Farmer Brown said, he said, last week, an earthquake hit my hen house. Now all my hens are laying blank eggs. Earthquake hit my hen house. Now all my hens are laying blank eggs.
Got anything
worth stealing, honey? That's it. Very good. Okay. You got rhythm, Charles.
All my eggs are laying what, dear? What kind
all
of eggs?
All my hens are laying blank eggs.
Oh, blank eggs.
Blank eggs. That's the word you have to fill in there.
Oh.
Now, this week.
I got it.
Okay.
I got it.
There we go. Come over here to Velma Murray. She's been thinking very hard.
Oh, yeah.
Farmer Brown said last week an earthquake hit my hen house. Now all my hens are laying blank eggs.
Broken?
Broken.
It's cracked and broken the same
cracked
thing?
Cracked and broken okay. would be the same thing, yeah. That's what you want. Now, that's not a bad answer. When I got to thinking about it, that's the first thing that popped into my head, but several other answers came into my head, too. Jimmy, what'd you say?
Well, now that you're leaving, Velma, it's,
We'll be the judge of that.
This is the correct answer that would have won you the ball game. Scrambled eggs.
Scrambled. Now, don't make her feel bad, because a cracked egg is not a bad answer. You know, scrambled is good. I must say that. Brett,
thank
what do you,
you very
say?
Much.
Velma, you've been one of the nicest contestants we've had in 2.5 years. Thinking of my own drinking habits, for some odd reason, I said boiled.
Boiled, yes, of course. Well, the heat of the earthquake would boil the eggs. Charles?
I'd like to say goodbye to you, my dear. You were wonderful. Scrambled.
Scrambled. Got to match the remaining ones, Velma, to stay in the game. Let's see what happens here. Kate, it's up to you.
I've got that old scrambled
egg. Scrambled. What do you have? Scrambled. Okay, Julie wins the game. Come on down, Julie. Congratulations. Well, we do indeed have to say
can
goodbye.
Can I kiss Richard goodbye?
What's that?
Can I kiss Richard goodbye?
Yeah, she wants to kiss you goodbye, Richard. Give her a little farewell kiss. They're doing a lot of kissing because all this time she's winning all this money. They're doing all this kissing there. Well, she's got $14,650. And she's very happy about that. And it was a pleasure meeting Velma Murray. There she goes. Now it's sending messages for you. We are ready. Is Julie ready?
Yes.
Okay, Julie. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Wig blank. Now, the answer that bunch of people gave most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the second most frequently given response, it's $250, and the third gets you $100. Now, you can call on anybody over here to suggest an answer for you.
Richard.
Wigwam.
Wigwam.
Charles, please.
I got it, Wub. I wanted to say, Wigman, keep those bottles quiet, but that's not the
end
of the song.
No, that was Milkman.
My father used to sing that song.
No?
Wigmaker, which
Walker
is a very popular audience choice.
What?
Wigmaker.
Wigmaker. All right. Hey.
Try not to have a rally. Thank you.
And Patty, please.
Ah! Here, hon.
Now, Patty, you're a college graduate.
Wig out.
Wig out. Yes. You got wig out, wigwam, and wig maker. Those are the three, Julie. Now, do you want one of those? You may have a better idea.
I'll take wigwam.
Wigwam.
What a good idea.
The audience says you're okay with that. We'll find out if you're okay or if you're not okay. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Wiglet. That's a little wig, isn't it? All right, we want wigwam.
Like
may we see the $250 response? Wigwag.
Wigwag.
What's that?
This is a strange experience, Julie. This may not work out the way we thought it was going to work out.
Wigwag?
I don't know what wigwag.
Wag is the past tense of wig.
Wag is the past tense of wig?
What is wigwag? Wigwag is like talking and chatting.
Oh, the signal for, the signal core. Yeah, they used to
wag is a dead wig.
Dog's tails go wag? Yeah. The signal corps, I remember they used to take those flags and wave them around, send messages to each other.
That keeps you out of the army in England.
That's right. All right, here's the last chance for wigwam. May we see the $500 response? Congratulations. We got the $500.
Wigwag.
I got a grand total of $600, Julie. But more important, you're going to play for 10 times $500 or $5,000. But to collect that amount of money, you got to match one of the celebrities, and this has to be an exact match. It's time to choose one now.
Richard, please.
Richard is chosen. Okay, swing around with your back to Richard. And here we go. Worth
$5,000. Savage.
Police blank. All right, he's made up his mind, we ask you to make up your mind. Give us an answer which you think will match his. Think hard now and give us an answer. Police.
Man.
Policeman. She says the audience is semi-applauding. A kasi-kasi answer. All right, Richard.
I could die.
Why?
Because that's what I wrote. And then I remembered there's a television show that's a big hit. I wrote
story.
But I wrote Man and Threw It Away.
Oh. They're both really good. That was a tough choice.
Darling. I just had that feeling that, you know, you probably watch television. And
I do.
Do you know the police story, Sherry?
Yes, I do.
No. Oh. Well, listen, you got the $600, and you're not going to watch it again, are you? and you got the $600, you're going to meet another challenger. Here comes Barry Cass.
Hi, Gene.
How are you?
All right, thank you.
This is Barry Cass, and he's going to tell us the story of his life right now.
In 10 seconds. I'm a law student from Chatsworth, and I'm married. My wife's an engineer, and we met when we were matched by a computer.
No kidding. Yeah. Where was that, here in Los Angeles?
Yes, here in Los Angeles.
And you're a law student. How many years do you have to go?
2.5.
2.5. Now, you must have done something before that.
Off and on.
Oh, I see.
Went to school.
Yeah. Okay, good luck here, Barry.
Thank you.
And good luck in your legal career. Shall we begin? A or B, Barry?
I'll try B.
B for Barry. Here we go. The Galloping Gourmet said, "Today I'm preparing a dish that will make anyone gallop. The main ingredient is blank."
Make anyone gallop.
Galloping Gourmet said, "Today I'm preparing a dish that will make anyone gallop. The main ingredient is..."
I think I got it.
Okay, that's one good choice. Yes, indeed.
Well, what others are there?
I'll tell you later. That's good. All right. Everybody's ready? We'll call on Barry. The Galloping Gourmet said, you know who he is.
Yes.
He says, "Today I'm preparing a dish that will make anyone gallop. The main ingredient is..."
Prunes.
Prunes. Show us your answer, Jimmy.
No, of course. The Black Prince forges ahead with...
prunes. One for Barry. Okay, Brett?
You're not going to believe this.
What?
I started to say horses.
Horse meat would have been a good answer.
Was it?
Oh, horse meat would have been a good answer.
Say, but then I said, oh, well, criminy Dutch, good gravy, Marie,
you honest said all
to
that,
liver,
huh?
Prune.
Prune. Who's a Barry? Charles?
I'm upset. I said beans.
Okay.
They don't make you gallop. They make you do something else.
Enough of that, if you please. Kate Jackson. I'm preparing a dish that'll make anyone gallop. The main ingredient is...
Not quite enough of that. Beans.
I see. And Richard.
I said police story.
You said police story. Yes, of course. Naturally.
Prunes.
Prunes. Now, Patty.
Yo.
Show and tell.
Well, see, I took it a little more literally.
Oh.
I said trigger.
Oh, trigger. The main ingredient is trigger.
You remember her.
Okay, Barry, that's three for you, and yours is yet to come, but right now, this for you.
Today's consolation prizes are Hoover's Tri Pan. The top floor is the middle fries and the bottom warm, just like having three appliances in one. Tri Pan from Hoover. And a hot tray and golden grain macaroni and cheddar dinners with enriched elbow macaroni and creamy cheddar cheese, golden grain macaroni and cheddar. And cosmetics from Mary Kay for your skincare, including an assortment of Mary Kay Queen's lotions, glamour makeup, and men's toiletries. Remember, there was an old lady who lived in a shoe and she had so many blanks she didn't know what to do. So she watched Match Game 76. We'll be back in a minute.
Hello there. Now, we're ready to go on here. He's had his question, and he did fairly well with it. You know,
yes,
three for a first rounder is not bad
did.
At all.
What were you ready?
Bot cameraman. I say, they're beautiful. Yes. I love all cameramen. They're so talented. Listen, you all know the song, Walking My Baby Back Home. You know that song.
Walking Gee, but it's my great baby after staying out late.
Walking my baby back home.
We'll call you. Thanks for coming in.
What?
We have your name and number. We'll call you.
Anyway, there's a new song written by the meanest man in the world, and it's called Blanking My Baby Back Home. Written by the meanest man in the world called Blanking My Baby Back Home. Okay. Good, good. Good.
Thank you, Jimmy. Goody, he just told me goody, I had a good,
good
answer.
For you.
He has had
goody
a good answer
me.
All week long. Now telling me
I hope
I
you're satisfied, you rascal, you.
Talking about calling the kettle.
Okay, Julie Wingate. You know that song?
I've heard it. My father used to sing it.
Very good. That's it, Julie. You know the song.
Do you need to answer the question?
Oh, yeah, no, you got to go on there. Now, there's a new song written by the meanest man in the world, and it's called Blankin' My Baby Back Home.
The meanest man in the world.
The meanest man wrote this one.
Beating My Baby Back Home.
Beating My Baby Back Home. We'll find out right now, Jimmy. Show and tell.
I think this should be a match. I think it is close to the answer. I said punching my baby back.
Punching is one. There's one. What do you say, Brett?
I have a little piece of advice for Julie.
Yes.
She must not say, my daddy used to sing it to me with a panel of this age, Julie.
Oh, right.
It makes us all very nervous and cranky. I think this is a match, and that's what she's going to get if she doesn't shape up. Kicking my baby back home.
No, kicking and beating
well,
are two different
punching
things.
Punching and...
No, punching is a form
Sorry.
Of beating. Kicking is... Got me. What do you say, Charles?
I didn't know the song, so I didn't answer. I'm much too young.
Sure.
You see, the baby was a square, so to be really mean, he rolled her. Rolling my
rolling
baby.
Rolling my baby.
Oh, see, she was square,
was
and when...
Yeah. Song written by the meanest man in the world. It's called Blanking My Baby Back Home, and Julie said beating or punching or anything like that.
I said kicking.
Kicking,
kicking
all right.
My baby back
two
home.
Kicks and two punches.
This guy was really...
really mean.
Really mean.
How mean was he, Richard?
He was whipping his baby back home.
Oh, he loved it.
Oh, yes. Lash LaRue recorded
yes,
it.
Yes, that's right. He had this big black whip. She loved every minute of it. What do you say there?
Well, it's not in meter.
No?
No, but disfiguring my baby back home.
Oh, well, 3-1 the score. Now we go on to round two and ask you to make a decision.
I'll stick with B.
B it is. Three people play. They are Charles, Kate, and Patty.
Oh.
The India rubber man said to the doctor, he said, Doc, you got to help me. Every time I blank, I bounce.
What, dear?
Don't confuse us. The India rubber man said to the doctor, Doctor, you got to help me. Every time I blank, I bounce.
Uh-huh.
Every time I blank, I bounce.
Uh-huh.
On the highest tree of crow.
I'm trying to help Charles.
Crow.
Now he needs...
Charles is finished.
Charles is finished?
You gotta help me every time I blank a bounce. Okay, lay it in there. Here we go. Barry, the India rubber man, said to the doctor, Doc, you gotta help me. Every time I blank, I bounce.
Fall.
What?
Fall. Boom.
Fall.
Fall down, go boom.
Yeah. One would expect the India rubber man to bounce if he fell. Wouldn't one?
Yeah.
I rest my case.
Now, I think Charles. You're adorable.
I think he's adorable, too. Charles?
See, if she was square and he rolled...
That's
oh,
enough
no.
of that.
Sit.
Every time I sit, I bounce. Mmm. All right, they're not helping you, Barry.
No, Kate? Young man, don't.
Every time I sneeze.
Sneeze is a good one.
I bounce.
Every time you sneeze, I bounce. Patty?
Burp.
Every time you burp, I bounce. Here's another good one. All right, some goodies there. Now, when we come back from this commercial message, Julie, you got to match 2 to tie 3 to win. And now this commercial message of interest to one and all gathered here on this day. Well, that's it. You've done it again. You've done it again.
What did we do?
Seemed like an 8-minute show because you were so gay and charming and literate and witty. And we'll look forward to seeing you on The Rookies and you in Good Times. And
I'll be at Newbury's.
You'll be at Newbury's.
They've made him manager.
They made him manager of Newbury's.
Lingerie.
Who will be here the next time?
Next time we get together on this very stage. These are the ones you'll see.
Avery Shriver. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Ryder. Joanne Flood. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flyer. See? Can't win them all.
Team Maverick here. Join us next time for Match Game 76. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. Stay tuned for title series next over most of the CBS stations.